sense of how much you've made from being a donor?
Yeah, and I drop off between 4 to 6 samples a week. I get paid $40 per sample, so, you know, you can do the math.
We've put all kinds of foreign things in our bodies. From swords to pool balls and even squeaky toys. But have you ever heard of a poop transplant?
Ew.
How can someone else's poop save your life? Can you make money from donating your leftovers? And would you take a poop pill? This is Your Body On, Getting a Poop Transplant. An FMT, or fecal matter transplant, is a procedure where surgeons take healthy processed fecal matter from a donor and transplant it into your colon. The practice dates back to ancient China, around 1,700 years ago. A 4th century Chinese researcher, Gehong, used feces in a yellow soup to help treat patients with severe diarrhea and food poisoning.
It's coming out of me like lava!
Now that's a soup of the day I'll be skipping. The practice eventually made its way into Western culture. During World War II, German soldiers used camel stool to treat bacterial dysentery. Nowadays, it's a common practice that is helping save lives. But why would you want someone else's poop in your body?
Pooping?
I've got a gut feeling you might know why.
Gotta go with your gut.
The microbiome. Our bodies are comprised of trillions of microorganisms that make up our microbiome. This bevy of bacteria helps protect you from diseases, breaks down complex foods, and synthesizes important vitamins like B12. A healthy gut is diversified, like a good investment portfolio. You don't want to go all in on one stock, Tesla, just like you shouldn't only eat cheeseburgers. A wide variety of bacteria will keep your gut balanced in acidity and arm it to fight off nasty pathogens. If you're familiar with the saying, you are what you eat, well, I'm afraid it's true.
Am I in heaven?
Many foods contain microbiota, which makes them probiotic. This includes yogurt, dark chocolate, and sauerkraut.
Delicious.
We get our first exposure to this healthy gut bacteria from breast milk.
Milk?
But if your diet is poor and lacks probiotics, you're more likely to bloat and get embarrassing gas. Wasn't me.
Oh, damn!
Who needs poop? If you've ever been on antibiotics to treat an infection, there's a reason why you should limit how many pills you take. For some people with sensitive stomachs, going overboard with antibiotics won't just wipe out the bad bacteria, but the good as well. This can make you vulnerable to the bacterium Clostridium difficile, or C. diff for short. About 500,000 people in the US are infected with C. diff every year, and 15,000 die from it. This nasty critter infects the large intestine with a vengeance, and it will spread if no good bacteria can stave it off. Symptoms can include diarrhea, fever, nausea, and abdominal pain. If left untreated, it can lead to colitis, sepsis, bowel perforation, and even death. But thankfully, if you play your cards right, a little healthy poop is all you need. Finding a donor. So, how does one go about getting an FMT? Well, first, you'll need a donor. And it can't be just anyone off the street. So don't even think about asking your roommate for a sample and trying the procedure yourself.
You don't need a fecal transplant.
To be a donor, a medical team will have to screen you first. To start, you have to be antibiotic-free for 6 months. You'll also need a clean bill of health with no history of sexually transmitted infections, gastrointestinal conditions, or illegal drug use. And any recent tattoos or piercings are a no-go. If that sounds like you, congrats. You could make up to $40 for your poop. Now that's money you don't want to flush down the drain. The poop-cedure. Before the procedure, you'll want to stop taking any antibiotic medication 2 days prior. In most cases, you'll get a colonoscopy by a gastroenterologist. Doctors may ask you to stick to a clear liquid diet with some laxatives thrown in for good measure. This is to flush your system, quite literally. They'll turn you over on your side, and the donor poop will be deposited through a tube in the area where the large intestine meets the small intestine. Don't worry, you'll be sedated for this part, and it'll be over in half an hour tops. You might need to take anti-diarrhea medication afterward so that the healthy poop stays in place.
Wait, what?
If this freaks you out, in some situations you can get poop pills that can be swallowed or delivered by an enema. Doctors will freeze the donor's feces and place it into a small capsule. Tasty. Stinky science. While FMTs are primarily used for people suffering from C. diff, a 2021 clinical trial showed some evidence that it may help treat people with autism spectrum disorder. Believe it or not, certain bacteria in your gut can influence your mood and mental well-being. Research has shown that Caprococcus bacteria can affect your production of dopamine.
I'm sad.
For some people lacking in this bacteria, it can contribute to depression. In 2022, a groundbreaking study found that two patients' depressive symptoms significantly improved for up to 8 weeks after receiving a fecal transplant. While more research is needed, it's clear that a little poo can go a long way. But what would happen if you didn't poo at all? How long could you hold it in? We'll test the waters on another episode of Your Body On.